Okay, I'm back with another video. So in today's video, I'm sure you guys can tell by the title, I am going to be giving you guys my thoughts on that makeup routine that I tried by Scott Barnes. But before we get into the video, you guys know what I ask. If you like the content that I post, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell for post notifications, and if you like the video, just like the video. Also, comment down below. You guys know I love engaging with you guys in the comment section. I did also want to say thank you for my new supporters. Thank you for the supporters who have been supporting me from day one. I appreciate that. And if you're not already subscribed, I see you guys are watching my videos. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But yeah, let's just get right into the video. So I tried out that Scott Barnes Tati makeup tutorial, and for me it was a fail for multiple reasons. It was a fail on the products and the technique because I couldn't get it down in the first video. So let's just put that out there. I do love the technique. I have implemented some of it into my regular routine, which is how I did my makeup today. I feel as though I see a night and day difference from what I was doing before to what I'm doing now. So the reason I said again that it was a fail, I didn't have the right products. I probably should have looked at the video before I decided to do the video, but I didn't. I decided to just go on a whim. I made it work. I looked decent on camera, but up close I looked a hot mess. So that's why I called it a fail. I didn't have the right products. I used some foundation that was a little bit mattifying, so it dried, as you guys saw. I had to make do with some fix spray to just loosen it up. It was a work in progress, but needless to say, some of the things that I picked up in that video is I like how he contoured the cheeks and contoured your jawline. I've definitely implemented that into my routine. I'm definitely going to be using that going forward. I just feel as though it gives my face more of a lift, and I need that because I'm old. So definitely going to be implementing that going forward. I like how he contoured the lips. I don't like how he contoured the nose. The nose contour that he did, it worked for her. It didn't work for me. I have a little bit wider of a nose than she did. She does. Let's clarify that. Then she does. So I went back to my old nose contouring, which is where, you know, you still do the line in the middle and I just contour here and underneath. I just like the way that looks better for me. I do my eyeshadow and my eyebrows before. The main reason is because I noticed when he was doing the eyebrows and he did them afterwards, there's no like cleanup with the concealer, so however they look, they looked. I like my eyebrows look a little bit more defined than I felt with me doing them after. It looked messy for me. So do my eyebrows, my eyeshadow before, but everything about how he mixed the foundation, the concealer, like the different shades, I absolutely loved it. And like I said, it's, you know, I've gone back to my old ways with some things, but for the most part, a lot of what he did face wise I kept. I definitely love that. I am going to be working on it. One thing that I do also like is that it shortened my makeup time a lot. In addition to that, like, I don't use as much product on my face. So before, when I was doing my makeup, I would put on foundation all over my face, and then I put concealer where I need to put concealer, and then put the contour where I need to put contour. So that's in some places 2 and 3 layers, whereas if you do it the way that he instructs you to do it, I'm only putting concealer where concealer needs to go, contour where contour needs to go, foundation where foundation needs to go. If you guys get the gist of things. So you're using a lot less product, which in turn, I think, makes it look a lot more natural and makes it look a lot lighter. So that's definitely one of the things that I've picked up and I will continue to do. I will perfect it. If you guys would like to see how I got this makeup look, you can't really see it that well. I'm going to try to insert a picture up here or here. I don't want to say in better lighting, but so you guys can really see what this makeup looks like, because sometimes my camera doesn't really do it any justice. So if you guys want me to recreate this look and what I've taken from his makeup routine and how I've implemented that into my normal routine, comment down below, let me know, and I will do that for you guys. But that wraps up this video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.